Okay, what up, everybody? This is Mr. Stan. Today we're going to talk about how to use sine, cosine, and tangent. So this is basically for those of you who are just learning this for the first time, or if you haven't used it for a long time, you just want a quick refresher. So we're going to be talking about how to use it to solve for sides in a right triangle. Right. So basically all that sine, cosine, and tangent are their ratios. Right, so it means one number divided by another number. And so here we have a triangle, and we have the hypotenuse here, which is always the longest. And we're just going to say C for that one. And then here is an angle between two of the sides. And B over here represents the opposite side. So that's like the side that's not touching this angle in any way. If you imagine this angle is like a telescope, B would be the side it's looking at. Then A represents the adjacent side. The adjacent side is a side that helps make up this angle, but it's not the hypotenuse, right? So that's what AB, so AB and C stand for the length of those sides. Now sine is just the length of B divided by the length of C. Cosine is the length of A divided by the length of C. And tangent is the length of B divided by the length of A. Right, and so sine, cosine, and tangent can be used to find missing sides of a triangle if we know enough information. So let me give you an example. Let's say that we know that this side is 20 meters. All right, and then we know that this angle is, let's say, 40 degrees. Okay, so with that, using normal algebraic methods, we would not be able to find A and B, but using sine and cosine, we can. And so let's find A first, and I'll show you how it's done. All right, we want to find A. And so we need one of these that has both A, which is what we don't know, and C, which is what we don't know, which we do know. Okay? And so that would be this one here, cosine. Then I'm just going to write cosine up here. So cosine theta equals A over C. Okay, but you'll notice that we know what the angle is. Theta is just a Greek letter that stands for an unknown angle. But now I put a number there, so it's known. So we'll put cosine 40 degrees equals, and then we don't know what A is, but we know what C is. It's 20, so there we go, right? So this is now the equation that we got from using sine, cosine, and tangent, right? Okay, so now we're just going to have to use algebra to make A be on a side by itself, and then that will tell us how long the side A is. So we want to get rid of this 20, so what do? We'll multiply by 20. This side and this side. What you do to one side of an equation, you have to do the other. That causes these 20s to cancel out, and you get A is equal to 20 times cosine 40. Right, so in a calculator, you just do 20 multiplied whatever cosine 40 is. So that is now something you can put in a calculator. On our tests, you don't have to even put that in a calculator. You can just write it as 20 of cosine 40. Right, and that would be good enough. Okay, so to solve for B, we're going to do the same thing. This time we need one of these that has B, which we don't know, and C, which we do know. Right, and so B and C would be this one right here, sine. So come over here and sine theta equals B over C. Right, so there's the equation, and once again, I'll write down, I'll replace the unknowns with the things we know. So we know the angle is 40 degrees, and we know that C is 20. So sine 40 degrees is equal to B over 20. Right, and then we'll just use algebra to get B on a side by itself. So like last time, we have to multiply both sides by 20. There, that crosses out. We have to multiply this side by 20 to keep them equal. And so you get B is equal to 20 sine of 40 degrees. All right? And that is something that you can put inside a calculator and get a actual number for. But as I said, on our test, you're allowed to leave it like that. All right?